This is the variable radius r dam. The radius of exodus curves, manje kay? Outside curve surface and intodos, inside curve surfaces, vary at various elevation. वेगवेगळ्या elevation ला the radius काय होता? Change होत जातं. It vary as the height changes at different heights of the dam. The radius will be different at various elevation, inside curves and outside curves. Being maximum at the top and certain minimum at its bottom. Top ला किती असते radius? जास्त असते. Bottom ला कमी असेल. Therefore, it is called variable radius R dam, which is having radius of the exodus curves and intodos curves vary at various elevations, being maximum at the top of the dam and minimum at the base. Therefore, this type of dams are called variable radius R dam. Samajla variable radius, doni madhe kay difference hai? Constant radius and variable radius. Constant radius mein radius constant hai, which is the radius is the point will lie on same vertical line. But in this variable radius R dam, the points which are located at various elevations, their centers may be different. This makes the central angle as large as possible so that the maximum arch efficiency may be obtained at all elevations. The central angle kaisa hai? Large hai. So maximum arch efficiency is obtained at all elevations. Central angle of this arch is large. This is the image of variable radius R dam. Samajla, the dotted line which shows the variable radius, variable curve. वेगवेगळे पॉइंट या हॉरिझॉन्टल लाईन वर वेगवेगळे पॉइंट घेतलेले आहेत. प्रत्येक रेडियस हे डिफरंट आहे. देअरफोर इट इज कॉल्ड व्हेरिएबल रेडियस. सेंटर हे व्हेरिएबल आहे, व्हेरिएबल सेंटर. समजलं? The downstream face of the dam at the center line is vertical. The design of such dam, which includes downstream face of the dam at the center line, is vertical. Downstream face kaisa hai? At the center line, it is vertical. This. While at all other locations, there is a better on the both sides, except at the abutments. Other location la, bagicha location la, except abutment. Abutment sodun the bagicha location center la, center pasun te abutment parent. Kai slope provide kele, better provide kele. There is a better on both the sides of the center of the dam. Again, the upstream side becomes vertical. If overhangs are permitted due to availability of stronger foundation, then the faces at the crown as well as abutments may be provided with overhangs, affecting saving in the design thickness. Sometimes overhangs also provided in the arch dam. Center of various arch rings is at different elevations, do not lie on the same vertical line. This is the centers of the various arch rings, various arcs, which are located at different elevations, and they do not lie on same vertical line. This is constant radius madhe ekas line var astat, vertical line var. But in this case they will lie on at different elevation along a vertical line. Therefore, it is called variable center arch dam. Tell us, camera, sir. Variable center arch dam. Such dams are prepared for V-shaped valleys as compared to the constant drainage arch dams, which may be prepared for comparatively wider U-shaped valleys. The constant radius arch dam, which are prepared for wider U-shaped valleys. U-shaped valley asel tar the constant radius arch dam getat. And V-shaped valleys asel tar variable radius arch dam for V-shaped valley. इमेज में दाखल पा वी शेप वैली असेल तर वेरिएबल रेडियस आर डैम वैल्यू ऑफ द रिवर शेप कसा असेल वी शेप जर असेल वी शेप वैली इन दैट केस वेरिएबल आर डैम्स आर प्रिफर्ड एंड व्हेन द शेप ऑफ द वैली इज हैविंग यू शेप्ड देन द कांस्टेंट रेडियस आर डैम्स आर प्रिफर्ड इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन वेरिएबल रेडियस आर डैम एंड कांस्टेंट रेडियस आर डैम. It depends upon the profile of the river, shape of the valley. त्यावर ते depend आहे. कुठल्या type चा arch dam घ्यायचा हे shape of the valley वर depend आहे. If V-shaped valley is there, then variable radius arch dams are preferred. If radius of if the shape of the valley is having U shape, then the constant radius arch dams are preferred. And last one, constant angle arch dam. This is a diagram of constant angle arch dam. This is a plan and this is cross section. See this? This is upstream side, downstream side. Constant angle kiti hai? Having theta 1330 degree 34 minute. This is a angle kiti hai? Constant angle. Angle is constant. Central angle. But radius is variable, angle constant hai. Therefore, it is called constant angle arch dam. This is a cross section which is taken at section 3-4 upstream face. It is 3-4 and this is 1-2 center la 1-2. It is shown in the section 1-2. The cross section dakhole. This is a section of 3-4. Ite eva curve shape hai. This is upstream face, this is downstream face. This is a overhang at crown, center la the overhang portion hai. This is a river width at top. This is the flow of the river from left to right. Constant angle arch dam is special type of variable radius arch dam. Variable radius se to special type hai. This is a modification on constant angle arch dam. त्यावरनं ते बनलेलं आहे. कॉन्स्टंट अँगल आर्च डॅम इज अ स्पेशल टाईप ऑफ व्हेरिएबल रेडियस आर्च डॅम इन विच द सेंट्रल अँगल्स ऑफ द हॉरिझॉन्टल आर्च रिंग्स आर ऑफ द सेम मॅग्निट्यूड. अँगल्स ऑफ दिस हॉरिझॉन्टल आर्च रिंग्स विच आर हॅविंग सेम मॅग्निट्यूड. त्याचं अँगल कसं आहे? सेम आहे. ऍट ऑल इलिव्हेशन दिस अँगल इज सेम. द डिझाईन ऑफ सच डॅम which is made by adopting the best central angle of 1330 degree 34 minute. This is the angle, central angle kiti aste 1330 degree 34 minute. Yeah, diagram ma dakhole pa constant angle theta is equal to 1330 degree 34 minute. A is a constant angle hai central la, samajhla. Hence, such dam, which proves to be most economical out of the three types of ordinary arch dams, the thin type peksha, the angle kasa hai? This type of dams are more economical than the other types, than the constant radius arch dam and variable radius arch dam. Thin peksha, duni peksha hai, economical hai. So, design of such dams involves providing overhang at overhangs at abutments which require stronger foundation. And if the foundation is strong, in that case, these overhangs are provided. Overhangs at abutments. Okay. Samajh la constant angle arch dams. So last one, forces acting on arch dam. This happen forces pile forces acting on gravity dam. Similarly, there are different forces acting on arch dam. So these are the various types. So which are the forces acting? Water pressure, uplift pressure, earthquake forces, silt pressure, wave pressure, and ice pressure. As you have seen gravity dam, the different forces acting on the gravity dam, similar to that, these forces are acting on arch dam. So both are similar. Water pressure apan pahile gravity dam madhe, water pressure kasa kadaycha, uplift pressure kasa kadaycha, earthquake forces, silt pressure, wave pressure, ice pressure. So these are the various forces acting on the arch dam. Okay, samajh gaye. After this, we have seen different types of arch dam, constant radius arch dam, then variable radius arch dam, and constant angle arch dam. Samajh gaye itparyant. And lastly, the various forces acting on arch dam. These are the forces that are similar to gravity dam. Any difficulty? Samajh la. Please ask. Any difficulty? Samajh ka arch dam. Please ask. So here we have completed the arch dam.